so we are getting informations like a Samhita period. So there mainly the taila they are using for in preparing the foods, in preparing the foods. And also there are so many the tailas in so many adhikaras. Acharyas have explained about the external applications of oil, which will helpful in case of curing the diseases. Okay, so the taila or the oils which are having the medicinal values, apart from its it is used for the food preparations. So here in this context, mainly we are concentrating on its the food preparations and its benefits on the sharira. Okay, so here, as you all know, many of the food preparations we used to prepare with the help of the oils. So oils are the main base. Oils are the main base to prepare the foods, especially the curries or the vegetables preparations. Okay, so those preparations, the taila, it plays an important role. Okay, so apart from its the food preparations, there are so many the medicinal values are also there. So in olden days, mainly the tila taila they are using. So the word taila is derived from the tila, that is snehana, which means, so the generally the taila, you can say like these are the substances which are having unctuousness or snigdata will be present, or the pichala guna, snigdata and pichala guna will be present. So that type of nature drugs we used to call as the tailas. Okay, so usually these tailas we used to obtain from different sources, like we are obtaining the many of the tailas we are obtaining from the seeds. For example, like a groundnut, from the groundnut we are extracting the oil, that is groundnut oil, or sunflower oil. From the seeds of sunflower we are extracting the sunflower oil. There are so many oil we used to extract from the seeds. So apart from some of this, the tailas we are obtaining from leaves. For example, like tailaparna, the name itself, it indicates that it contains the most of the leaves, that is the oil glands will be present. If you squeeze it, so you can feel that the volatile oil will be present in the leaves. Tailaparna, Eucalyptus globulus, and so many the flowers also contains these oils. For example, the best example is lavanga. So when you take the sections, you can find the oil glands. Okay, when you squeeze, so you will get the oil from the cloves. Okay, so there are so many fruits from which we used to extract the oils. Okay, so there are different sources, the vegetable oil. Okay, and apart from that, Acharya Charaka has mentioned two types of the tailas. There is the taila yonis, mainly like the Audbida yoni and Jangama yoni. So Audbida yoni, that is, you can say like bija, patra, pushpa, moola, tvak. Okay, by using the different parts of the Audbida ravyas, that is Udbidya prithivyam jayate iti Audbidam, one which obtained from by piercing the soil. So such type of drugs we used to call as we used to obtain the tailas. Whereas the Jangama yoni, so as you all know, the Chaturvidha sneha, like Gruta, Taila, Vasa, Majja. So we used to say Chaturvidha snehas. So among them, the taila is the only one that is from the Audbhuta Dravya. The remaining Gruta, Vasa and Majja. So these are the three main sources we used to obtain from the Jangama Dravyas. Okay, so this is about the introduction about the taila vargas. So this is what I have discussed according to Charaka. So there are mainly two sources, plant sources and animal sources. So plant sources from the different parts of the plants, and animal sources, that is from different like the animals, like Gruta, Vasha and Majja. Okay, so in different areas, see, there are some like the coastal regions lean towards the coconut oil. The if you take the India, so in South India and the North India, so we are using the different types of oils for preparing the foods. So as you all know, in the Karnataka itself, we are using mainly, so like the groundnut oil or this sunflower oil, mainly we are using. But when you move to the Kerala, like they are using main the food preparation, the oil they are using as the coconut oil. As the coconut, they are abundantly growing, and they are using as the main the oil which are prepared, which are used for preparation of the different types of fruits. If you move to the North India, so where there are some parts like Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, there they are using like sarshapa taila. So mainly they are usually they are abundantly cultivating the sarshapa, and they are preparing the foods by using the sarshapa taila. But in olden days, most of the food preparations they used to prepare by using the tila taila. But nowadays it is come down. So depending upon the area, so depending upon the conditions, so they are using, even the depending upon the seasons also, we are using the different types of tailas, and that is the it is addicted to that the persons to that type of preparations. Okay, the best oils from the animal source, that is Bruta Taila and Vasamajja. So oils should be used, that is in the spring, Atman and rainy season. So throughout the year, we used to prepare different types of foods by using the oils only. So okay, oils should be avoided during early hot and very cold weathers. That is depending upon the condition, you can use. So tailas are generally similar, the oils are having the similar properties as their source. For example, if you are obtaining the taila from the seeds, so whatever the properties of seeds are there, the same properties will be present in that taila. If you are obtaining the taila from the fruit, so the properties are is as same the properties of the fruits. Okay, so this in the first point used to says that tailas are generally similar in their properties to their source, that is oil seed or chief. Okay, so oil of sesamum possess their properties like the penetrating deep into the tissues, that is sukshma guna is there, tikshna guna is there, and vikasi guna, they used to spread throughout the body very fast, quickly. Okay, so in any same time in India, oil of the sesam was the chief edible oil. Okay, so in olden days, the tila taila is the main the source for prepare the different types of food preparations. Okay, so it was the chief edible oil in the olden days, and used both for cooking as well as for the treatment. See, both internal as well as external. So this is the only one, the oil we are using for internal administration as well as external applications also. Okay, so for internal administration in the form of aushadha and also in the form of food preparations, and for external applications we are using different preparations with a medicated the herbs. The term taila specially means the oil of tila. That is according to saugnya paribhasha prakarana, if they have not specified, if only they have mentioned taila, so you can take tila taila. If it is specifically mentioned, then you can take the specific type of taila. If it is not mentioned, means it is understood that taila means like tila taila, because it is considered as best, the taila among the taila, tila taila is considered as the best one, shreshtha. So the use of sesamum oil, that is tila taila, for cooking is gradually becoming less in recent time. Nowadays we are not using the tila taila for cooking the food preparations, only for medicinal purpose we are using that one. Okay, so the oil of groundnuts or the peanuts, coconut, mustard, rapeseeds, soybean, sunflower, etc. have been brought to use. Nowadays we are using these oils. Okay, so in the context of Ayurveda, it is sesamum oil only that should be used for internal administration of medicated oils. Even the medicated oils that is used for only internal administration, that is only tila taila. So there is no other the tailas they have not mentioned. Many other kinds of oils of medicinal values are described further. Okay, so some of the examples, please note down all these examples while explaining about the taila vargas. So mainly taila, as you all know in Dinacharya, there is abhyanga. For abhyanga artha, we are using the tailas for, this is for medicinal values. apart from that, like in case of Basti Kalpanas, we are using, and as a food preparations also we are using. Okay, so some of the examples like tila taila, that you can say like sesamum oil, bhumi gira taila. This is the second example, bhumi gira taila or bhusimbi taila. Bhumi gira taila or bhusimbi taila. Bhusimbi taila, that you can say groundnut oil or peanut oil. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಶೇಂಗಾ ಎಣ್ಣೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ತಿಲ ತೈಲ, ಭೂಮಿ ಗಿರ ತೈಲ. ದೆನ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸರ್ಷಪ ತೈಲ. ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಏರಂಡ ತೈಲ. ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅತಸಿ ತೈಲ. ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಕುಸುಂಬ ತೈಲ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾರಿಕೇಲ ತೈಲ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಧುಕ ತೈಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ತಿಲ ತೈಲ. Okay, so the oil obtaining from the seeds of tila, the definition of tila taila, the oil obtained from the seeds of tila, that is called as tila taila. Okay, so there are two types of tila, that is Shweta tila and Krishna tila. Both are having the same values. So tila taila, Murchita tila taila, for medicated, for in treating the diseases. The botanical source for tila, so already I think you have come across with the non-detailed drugs. Okay, the botanical source is Sesamum indicum. Sesamum indicum is the botanical source. Belongs to the Pedalaceae family. Sesamum indicum, Pedalaceae family. There is one more drug which comes under Pedalaceae family. That is Brahat Gokshura, that also belongs to the same family, Pedalaceae family. The vernacular names, Sesamum oil or Gingilly oil, Kannadadalli ellu athwa ellenne, in Hindi it is called til. Okay, this is the definition. The oil is obtained from, or the oil is expressed from the seeds of tila. That is called Sesamum indicum. It is called as tila taila. Okay, so this oil is said to be the best for medicinal use among the all type of oil. So tila taila is considered as the best oil, like the agra aushadas. So it is used both for external as well as internal administrations. The properties of tila taila. Okay, tikta kashaya madhura rasa, guru snigdha sukshma vishada guna. See the properties of tila, guru, snigdha, sukshma, vishada guna. So because of these properties only, it is considered as the agrya. So because which may penetrate a very minute the channels and does its actions. Okay, so guru, snigdha, sukshma, vishada guna, and madhura vipaka, ushna virya, dosha karmagnata is vata shamaka. So as you all know, the taila is the one which is best vata shamaka. So prabhava is kesha. So most of the Ayurvedic, the hair oils, the base of this oil is tila taila, as the even the base and the some of the drugs like the kalka dravyas and the kwata dravyas, whatever we are using, so those drugs are also having the kesha properties. So even the base is also having the kesha property. So as both are having the same properties, definitely it which will enhances the action. So the karma, that is the prabhava of tila taila, is kesha. Karma is having balya, varanya, tvachya, stanya janana, arthava janana. So because it is having ushna virya, so because of this it is arthava janana. And actually you have to take precautions where the persons are having or the persons who are taking these anticoagulant drugs like the ecosprin. So in these conditions it is contraindicated. The tila taila is contraindicated, the person who are consuming the anticoagulant medicines. Okay, because it is having tikshna guna, so it may create some complications. So arthava janana karma, virya vardhaka, buddhi vardhaka, danta roga hara. So especially we are using the tila taila, you will come to know in Swastha Rutta there are so many the preparations which are prepared by using the tila taila. That is used for kavala and gandusha, that is to treat the diseases related to the mukhagata vikaras. Okay, and also it is having agnivardhaka karma, See the benefits of tila taila. See, helps in treating the premature graying of the hairs. Treating the premature graying. So early, that is the whitening of the hairs. Premature graying of the hairs, as it is having the karma as kesha. Okay. So here, in case of the premature graying of the hairs, it is best medicine and also helps in lowering the blood pressure. While pulling for improving the oral health, that is in case of kaval and gandusha, you can do the kaval and gandusha by using the tila taila preparations. That is indicated in case of mukhagata vikaras. It also helps in the detoxification of the skin. That is as the karma of the tila taila is twachya. So because of this property only for abhyangartham. So every day you can apply the tila taila. So you will come to know that in panchakarma, a dry stick can be you can break or you can bend like the rubbers when you can fold like that, even the dry sticks, because of the daily application of or applying the these tila tailas. Okay, it is having the twachya, that is useful in case of detoxification of the skin, and also helps in preventing the diabetes. And also useful in case of rheumatoid arthritis, as you all in case of sandhivata. So there will be a sthikshaya is there, and also there will be a synovial fluid, the reduced quantity or the amount of synovial fluid in the joints. So that leads to there will be severe pain. So just if you do the abhyanga or if you apply the tailas, so which will reduces the pain. It also helps to fight stress and depression. Okay, helps in maintaining the good skin health. Acts as a natural anti-inflammatory agent and helps in natural of our anemia conditions. Okay. So these are some of the almost similar, that is helpful in case of mukhagata vikaras. That is boost the dental health by doing kavala and gandusha, promotes the healthy hairs. That is which will helpful in case of premature graying of the hairs. And also helpful in case of which improves the bones and protects against the atherosclerosis or heart attacks and strokes, and reduces the risk of osteoporosis, and helps in improving the growth of the bones, and also helps in treating the anxiety and also depressions, aids in reducing the appearance of age spots. So these are the some of the benefits of tila taila. So these are all some more benefits. Yes, next we'll move to the second taila, that is bhumigira taila or bhusimbi taila. You can select groundnut oil. So this is the natural method how they used to extract the groundnut oil. Okay, this is the natural method. By using peanut oil, by using the entras, they are extracting the groundnut oil. Okay, so the botanical source, Arachis hypogaea is the botanical source, belongs to the family Fabaceae family, that is Simbicula. Okay, in English it is called groundnut, kannadadalli nelagadale, athava in adu bhashe we used to call as shenga enni nelagadale, in Hindi it is called moongphali. Okay, so the definition, oil is expressed by grinding the seeds of groundnut, that is Arachis hypogaea, is called as bhumigira taila or groundnut oil. Okay, so this oil is said to be the best for cooking the food items. So groundnut oil, and nowadays even the sunflower oil, so that is also they are considering as a best one in protecting the some of the heart diseases. The properties, somebody it is vichitra pratyahara dravya, madhura tikta rasa, the oil. These are the properties usually in the introduction itself says that. So most of the times the oil and the seed are having the same properties, but sometimes it may differ. Okay, here it is having Ushna Virya. Madura Tikta Rasa, Guru Snigdha Guna, Katuvipaka, Ushna Virya. This is one of the Vichitra Pratyarabdha Dravya. So please remember the properties of Bhumi Gira Taila. This is not according to the Rasa or Pancha Bhutika Sangatana of Yadravya. So Madura Tikta Rasa, Guru Snigdha Guna, Ushna Virya, Katuvipaka. And does Kapha Vata Shamana Karma? Does Kapha Vata Shamana Karma? And the karmas like Balya, Brahmana, and Drushya. See, there are some of the benefits of this groundnut oil or peanut oil. Helps in improving the heart health. So there are so many research activities carried out on these cooking oil, especially this groundnut oil and sunflower oil. So those shows that, so which will helpful in case of preventing the cardiac disorders. Okay, helps in improving the heart health and also help in maintaining the cholesterol level. So it will not increase that much of cholesterol level like the palm oil and different the oil they are having low cost, they are using for food preparations. Okay, so that's why in food preparations you can use the groundnut oil or the sunflower oil, because which will helpful in maintaining the cholesterol level. Okay, and also helps to get rid of the acne and blackheads, and used in aromatherapy, and also helps in improving the hair health, and also helps in improving the blood flow, helps in lowering the high blood pressure, helps to prevent the stomach problems, and also provides the skin care. So some more the benefits of groundnut oil: it boosts the immune system, so which will increase the immunity power, and also helps in preventing the cancers and maintains the cholesterol levels, helps to lower the blood pressure, reduce the risk factors of heart attack or heart diseases, and protects against the symptoms of aging. That may be a premature graying of the hairs or some of the acne. Delays the onset of cognitive disorders such as Alzheimer's disease. So this is also one of the important actions. But the excessive intake of peanut oil may cause weight gain. So it should be in limited amount. So these are some more health benefits. Next we'll move to the sarsha taila. The taila obtained from the seeds of sarsha, that is Brassica campestris, belongs to the cruciferaceae family. Okay, so Brassica campestris belongs to the cruciferaceae family. In English it is called wild turnip, kannadadalli sasuve, in Hindi sarso. So there are so many hair oils by using these as a base. So tila taila is best, but apart from there are some conditions where there will be a fungal infection and some conditions they are using this sarshapa taila. Okay, apart from the tila taila, depending upon the condition you can change the base. So the oil is expressed from the seeds of sarshapa, that is Brassica campestris. So it is called as sarshapa taila, and this oil is said to be the best for cooking, especially in case of the North Indian states like Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, and those areas they are using, how we are using here as a groundnut oil or the sunflower oil, in the similar way their main food preparation by using the sarsha taila in North India. The properties: this is katu katu ushna, katu rasa lagu teekshna guna, katu vipaka ushna virya. I think we have discussed, while discussing about Khandugna Dravyas, we have discussed this Sarshapa, and also it is having the Rakshagna properties. Okay, there are so many the important actions. See, Khandugna Karma, Krimigna Karma, Shvitragna Karma, Medogna, and Arshogna. So these are the, according to Ayurveda, the important karmas of Sarshapa Taila. See, the some of the benefits of these mustard oils. Yes, in case of particularly about the heart the diseases. So mustard oil is rich with monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats. So mustard oil is rich with the monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats, which may help to balance the cholesterol level in the bodies. Okay, so because of these properties, it is useful in case of in preventing the heart diseases. It also is having antibacterial properties, that is Krimigna Karma. When consumed, mustard oil may fight the bacterial infections inside the colon. if you are administering the food preparations which are prepared by using the sarshama taila, so inside if there is an bacterial infection is there, so they used to control or they used to treat or they used to kill those bacteria inside the colon. Okay, so they used to fight the bacterial infections inside the colon, intestine, urinary tract and other parts of the digestive systems. And antifungal, so applied directly to the skin, the mustard oil can help fighting the fungal infections. So if there is an fungal infection on the skin or sometimes on the skull, if there is any fungal infection, so you can use the hair oil, which is the base is sarshama taila. Next we'll move to the castor oil. The oil obtained from the seeds of castor, that is aranda. Okay, these are the seeds of aranda. This is aranda taila. So the botanical source is Ricinus communis. As you all know, the Ricinus communis is the botanical source, belongs to the family Euphorbiaceae family. In English it is castor oil. Kannadadalli haralenne athava audala enne, haralenne athava audala enne. In Hindi it is called rendi. The oil is obtained by crushing the seeds of aranda. Actually the outer coat of the seed somewhat hard, you can remove that, inside that you will get the endosperm. If you squeeze, so you will get the oil. Okay, so the oil is obtained by crushing the seeds of aranda, that is Ricinus communis, is called as aranda taila. The pharmacodynamics are the rasa panchaka of aranda taila, madhura katu tikta kashaya rasa, madhura katu tikta kashaya rasa, guru tikshna guna. So this is very important property in case aranda taila. Madhura katu tikta kashaya rasa, see, guna is tikshna guna, madhura vipaka ushna virya. So this is also one of the vichitra pratyarabdha dravya, does kapha vata shamana karma. And as you all know, the aranda moolam rushya vata haranam sreshtam. Aranda moola is rushya and vata hara. In the similar way, even the aranda taila is also having the rushya and vata shamaka properties. Okay, kapha vata shamaka, deepana, rushya, twachya, rechana, krimigna and vayasthapana. Deepana, rushya, twachya, rechana, krimigna, vayasthapana. There are some the preparations. According to Shushruta, he used to prepare some of the food items by using the aranda taila, and some of the preparations like aranda payasa he used to advise in the conditions, especially the krura koshta persons, vata prakriti persons. If you want to treat, you can use the aranda taila, he used to say. Like in case of amavata conditions, so aranda taila is one of the best medicine to treat the amavata conditions. Okay, see the seven proven benefits of the castor oil. So the first one is hair growth. So castor oil stimulates the hair growth and can be used as a hair oil to thicken the hairs. If the hairs are thin, so and the hair growth will be less, in such type of conditions you can use the castor oil, the aranda taila. But the aranda taila is having more pichala guna, stickiness will be more. Okay, compared to the tila taila and sarshama taila, though the stick, the pichalatva or the snigdhatva of this castor oil will be more, but in some conditions you can use this oil. Apart from this is very important in case of cracked hair, that is in case of vipadika. I think already come across with the disease in roga nidana, vipadika, where there will be the cracked heels. So sometimes, especially in the women, they are very difficult in walking, and sometimes there will be a bleeding also, and where there will be a very roughness, the skin becomes very hard. So in such type of conditions you can cleanly wash the heels with hot water and some amount of salt, then you can apply this aranda taila. Okay, so cracked heels, the castor oil is easily absorbed by the skin and is a great treatment for the cracked heels. So it becomes smooth. So you can best you can apply at the night time while sleeping. You can wash the your foot cleanly and apply the aranda taila. So in early morning, once again you can wash with the hot water. So it will becomes very smooth heels. Yes, the third one is stretch marks. So this is also very important, and especially for the cosmetic purpose. So in case of the pregnancy, the pregnant woman after the delivery, during the pregnancy, as the fetus growth, the abdominal part, they used to stretch. So because of the stretching, the stretch marks will be present after the delivery. After the delivery, so 2-3 months or even the 6 month, the stretch mark will not disappear. So simple remedy, just you can apply the Eranda Taila over the stretch mark. Just you can do the massage wherever the stretch marks are there. So it can be continued for a few weeks. So it will disappear the stretch marks. There are so many, the preparations are also there by using this as the main base. Okay. Then apart from it, then healthy skin. So castor oil is high in protein and essential fatty acids. So it penetrates the deep into the skin and softens the hardest. So it will be hard skin is there. So as in case of cracked heels, okay, healthy skin. And also acne treatment. So in case of acne, it reduces the swelling and redness of the acne, kills the bacteria which causes it. So just over the face where the acne are there, just you can apply this castor oil. And beautiful nails, for beautiful nails, just you can massaging the castor oil on even the fingernails. So it will give the long and healthy and beautiful nails. And glowing lips, especially in case of the winter season, where there will be excessive, the dryness will be present in the environment. So because of that, the dryness, especially in case of water property persons, the lips becomes very hard and rough, and sometimes there will be bleeding also. So in such type of conditions, just you can apply the castor oil, so which will mix the medicine. You can it is going to act like a best medicine for the dry eyes. That is akshirukshata, where if the dryness develops, so you are unable to move the eyes. And also even sometimes of the eyelashes, there are some home remedies are there. So I'm going to explain those home remedies for the dry eyes and eyelashes. Okay, so castor oil is effective at thickening the eyelashes. As you all know, the eyelashes are does the protective function, okay, for the eyes. So it is also capable of preventing the breakage and can helps the stimulate the growth of the eyelashes. So how you have to apply the for eyelashes, this oil. So clean your face with the water and remove the any traces of makeup, especially from the eyes. Okay, take an eyeliner brush and slowly dip it in a castor oil oil. Make sure to use pure cold and pressed castor oil. Okay, pure castor oil. So carefully you can apply over the eyelashes, and it's better to apply at night before sleeping. So remove the makeup, that remover in the morning. So this is for eyelashes. Next for this dry eyes. Eyes drops for the dry eyes. Okay, so you can put the castor oil, that's pure castor oil. So natural way to treat the dry eyes, it's the best home remedy. 2 drops of castor oil will give a good result in case of the dry eyes. Apply this 1-3 times in a day. So 1-2 drops of a pure castor oil you can put in the eyes, especially the dry eyes. So in such type of conditions, which will help in nourishing the eyes. Okay, so castor oil moisturize the eyes and apply also eyelids, so which will reduce the irritations. And some more the benefits of the castor oil. This is also one more important the benefit of castor oil. Castor oil for eye wrinkles. So there are 2-3 the drugs are there. You can take 1 tablespoon of castor oil plus 1 tablespoon of olive oil and 2 tablespoon of milk, that is godugda. You can mix it properly, then you can add 1 tablespoon of rose water. Okay, 1 tablespoon of castor oil, 1 tablespoon of olive oil and 2 tablespoon of milk. You can mix it properly, then add rose water. So this preparation you can make a packs like the cotton. So you can dip in that the preparation and apply over the where the wrinkles are present just below the eyes. Okay, so which will you can do like this for twice in a week. So which will results which will reduces the eye wrinkles. For the cosmetic purpose, you can do this one. And yes, next we'll move to the another the important the oil, that is Atasi Taila. Atasi Taila, linseed oil or flax oil. If you search most of the modern the ointments, the modern analgesic ointments, like if you go and search like moo or any diclofenac the preparations ointments which are used for to relieve the pain, the main base is this Atasi Taila. Almost all the modern preparations, they are using this Atasi Taila, because Atasi, as you all know, I think in case of Atasi Upanaha, so which is indicated in case of like the Vidradi conditions, where there will be a severe pain is there. So in such type of where there will be a severe inflammation is there, severe pain is there, the heart diseases, especially where there will be the increased cholesterol level is there. In such type of conditions, you can use, because of this tikshna guna, because of this sukshma srotoghami guna. So if there is any obstruction in the srotasas, in the arteries or in the channels, so those obstructions will be broken by these tikshna guna, sukshma srotoghami guna. This is one of the best medicine to treat, or which will prevent the heart attacks or the strokes can be prevented by using the Atasi Taila. Okay, so the botanical source is Linum Usitetacimum. Linum Usitetacimum is the botanical source, belongs to the family Linaceae family, and the vernacular names is linseed, and or also you can call it flax oil. Okay, Kannadadalli Agasi Bija, or in Hindi it's called Alasi. So Atasi Taila is obtained from the seeds of Atasi. Atasi Taila is obtained from the Atasi, that is called as Atasi Taila. Okay, that is Linum Usitetacimum. The properties, this is also one of the Vichintra Pratyarada Dravya. Madhura Rasa Guna is Guru Snigdha Guna Katuvipaka Ushnavirya. Madhura Rasa Guru Snigdha Guna Katuvipaka Ushnavirya Vata Shamaka. So as you all know, the vata ruddhi, the pratyatmaka lakshana of vata ruddhi, that is the vedana. As it does vata shamana karma, definitely it reduces the vata shama, that is the shula is going to be reduces. So karmas like deepana, chakshushya, balya, vedana sthapana and tvachya. Yes, the linseed oil which will helpful in case of, see, it is having the omega-3 power in linseed or flaxseed oil to fight against the obesity. This omega-3 is present in this linseed oil. So because of this, which will fight against the obesity, and also in case of malignant growths, like the cancerous growth, in such type of conditions also it will fight. And also it is going to be useful in case of the hypertension and arthritis conditions, and in case of weak immunity. Some more benefits of this linseed oil or the flaxseed oil, that is promotes the hair growth, aids in weight loss. Okay, as it is mentioned in case of obesity conditions, flushes out the toxins. It is going to act like an anti-aging property. This having and helpful in case of making the smooth lips and radiant the skin, fade the acne scars, lighten the dark circles, and anti-acne. Some more the health benefits of flaxseed oil are, yes, like anti-cancer activity, which reduces the cancerous prevention, reduces the cholesterol level, relieves the inflammation, arthritis, helpful in case of bowel health, maintaining colon health, prevents the cardiovascular diseases, weight loss, prevents the dry eye syndromes, and healthy hairs. Next we'll move to the Narikila Taila. the taila obtained from the mature fruit part, the pulp of the narikela. Okay, that is Coccus nucifera, belongs to Arecaceae family. In English it is called coconut oil, kannada dali kobbari enne athwa tengin enne, in Hindi it is called nariyal tail. So the taila obtained from the matured dried pulp of the fruit, that is narikela, that is Coccus nucifera, that is called as narikela taila. So the properties, that is kashaya madhura rasa, kashaya madhura rasa guru snigdha guna madhura vipaka shita virya, and does vata pitta shamana karma. The properties are kesha balya and brahmana. Okay, see the some of the benefits of this narikela taila. So especially on the hairs, it reduces the protein loss and nourishes the hairs, and also in skin it prevents the wrinkles, sagging, dryness and flaking. On the immunity system, it strengthens the immune system and heart, it prevents the high cholesterol and blood pressure levels, and healing damaged tissues, liver, kidney diseases and the pancreatitis. Okay, on the head, if you massage, it eliminates the mental fatigue, and on candidiasis, it provides the relief and help to eliminate the candidiasis, that is albicans yeast. On the bones and teeth, improve the bone strength and the dental health. Okay, on the diabetes, controls the blood sugar level and provides the insulin secretions. Some more the benefits of the narikela taila. So in case of weight loss, cancer prevention, and boosts the digestion, prevents the candida, immune system. Okay, these are some more the important the properties of narikela taila. Yes, lastly we will move to the kusumba taila. So the taila obtained from the seeds of kusumba, that is Carathmus tinctorius. So these are the seeds of kusumba. So Carathmus tinctorius belong to the Asteraceae family. In English it is called safflower or false saffron oil, kannadadalli kusubi enne. In Hindi it is called kusumba. Okay, the kusumba taila is obtained from the seeds of kusumba, the bija, that is Carathmus tinctorius, is called as kusumba taila. The properties, it is having ambla rasa. So this is the one exception. Almost all what you have observed, some of them are madurasa, some of them are katurasa, but this is the only one oil which is having ambla rasa. So ambla rasa guru guna katu vipaka ushna virya, and this is tridosha vardhaka. This is exception to the, so most of the oil what we have discussed. Okay, this is tridosha vardhaka, and karma is pramehagna kandugna sandishotahara karmas. The benefits of this safflower oil: reduces the cholesterol, reduces the blood sugar levels, enhances the hair growth and nourishes the dry skin. Okay, it is an effective remedy against the vivacity also, and helps in keep the hair and scalp healthy, and also it boosts the quality and appearance of the skin, and aids in managing the diabetes, reduces the risk factors of atherosclerosis and strokes, and helps in regulating the cholesterol level in the body. Okay, and also helps to decrease the severity of premenstrual symptoms. Okay, so it should be avoid use of this safflower oil, the person who are taking the like anticoagulant medicines. Yes, the last and one more is maduka taila. Last one, in Hindi it is called mahua. This is maduka indica, that is maduka indica, belongs to Sapotaceae family. In English it is called butter tree oil or mahua tree, butter tree oil. Okay, kannada dali hippe enne, in Hindi it is called mahua tail. So the maduka tail is obtained from the maduka plant, especially from the fruits. The maduka indica is called as, that is maduka taila. So kashaya madura rasa, kashaya madura rasa guru snigdha guna madura vipaka shita virya, and vata pitta shamaka, and the karma is kesha tvachya balya and brahmana. Kesha tvachya balya and brahmana. So these are the classical the actions according to Ayurveda. Okay. So this by this I want to conclude the today's topic, that is about Taila Varga. So okay. So in the next class we'll see another varga, that is Aharopayogi Varga.